Can't I just copy everything to back up? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. For security, in case of a crash, can I just copy everything, like my entire C drive, to an external drive as a backup rather than using a backup program? At the present time, I'm just copying my documents to a flash drive, but I'm concerned that to recover, I would have to rebuild all the files and updates if I had a crash. Sure, you can do that. Just copy everything. Honestly, it provides a level of protection, and it's way better than doing nothing at all. But your safety net has some really, really big holes in it. The problem is that you can't really copy everything. You'll miss some things that a traditional backup program would catch, things you'll care about when the worst happens. The scenario proposed here is to back up C by copying all of it to an external drive like F. If you're familiar with the Windows command prompt, it might look something like this. /E/H(C:\F:\). There may be other options that would make sense, but I've included the important ones to copy the contents of all files and folders from the root of the C drive to the root of the F drive, and to copy hidden and system files as well. It would have to be run as administrator to pick up the files that normal accounts don't have access to. In theory, it seems simple, and conceptually it's oh so close to what a backup program does, but it misses a few important things. Many important files are not backed up by this approach. Most importantly, many files open in running programs at the time of the backup will not be copied. And some files are always in use. The most notable might be the Windows registry, the storehouse of settings and configurations used by Windows and installed applications. If Windows is running, files containing the registry are locked from outside access. Without the registry, if your hard drive were to die, you're still looking at a complete reinstall of Windows followed by a complete reinstall of your applications onto a replacement drive. Registry, honestly, just the tip of the iceberg. Windows has many other files open when it's running, and they therefore won't be backed up with a simple copy procedure. Other applications may also be running with locked and uncopyable files. Backup programs are specifically designed to have access to protected files and files in use. In other words, a backup program really can copy everything. There are a couple of other less critical yet handy benefits to using a backup program. Most backup programs are easy to set and forget. Once configured, they run in the background, backup automatically. Yes, of course, test your backups, but you won't have to waste much energy thinking about them regularly. They'll just happen. But there's an interesting scenario in which a backup program can save the day that doesn't involve a hard disk crash or other catastrophic failures. Imagine this scenario. You create an important file. I'll call it version 1. Your nightly file copy backup, copy everything backup, backs it up. The next day you change the file. Call it version 2. Your nightly file copy then backs up version 2, overwriting version 1 in the backup. The next day, you realize that those changes to version 2 were a horrible, horrible mistake. You really want version 1 back, but it's gone. It's been overwritten everywhere, including in your backup, by version 2. Had you been using a good backup program, that scenario might have had a different outcome. Imagine this instead. You create an important file. Once again, it's version 1. Your backup software creates a full image backup of your hard drive, including that file. The next day, you change the file to create version 2. Your backup software creates an incremental backup, backing up only those files that have changed since the previous backup, including version 2. The next day, the same realization hits. Version 2 was a disaster, and you need to revert to version 1. In this scenario, an incremental backup has two important differences from the copy everything approach. It only adds files to the backup. It never deletes them. It only adds files that have changed since the previous backup. That means that version 1 of your file is still there, ready to be recovered with your backup software. In practice, I configure my backup software to do this. Create a full image backup of everything once a month. create an incremental image each night of everything that's changed that day. And then I save everything for at least 2 months. That means I can revert any file to the state it was in on any day in the preceding 60 days. Now, aside from the files in use problem I talked about earlier, you could probably devise a system using batch files and copy operations that mimics much of this. But a backup program is more reliable, easier to use, and worth every penny. Now, to be fair, there are scenarios where simple file copies work well enough. For example, I have some drives that contain only data. No files are in use in the middle of the night. I just copy or mirror those drives to other drives nightly using a simple file copy operation, much like the command line example I showed you earlier. There's no need for a more sophisticated backup, and the mirrored drive is simply there on my network, ready to be used at any time. Copying files to a backup can also be a space saver under a couple of conditions. You know, and I mean you really know, which files you should back up and which you don't need. Often that's as simple as having all of your data in a separate drive, partition, or folder. And you back up your system drive using a backup program, or you plan on reinstalling the operating system and all applications from scratch in case of a catastrophic failure. It's a completely valid way to back up, as long as you know it's sufficient for your situation. For many people, a complete reinstall would mean a couple of days of lost work, whereas a backup program could have taken care of it in an hour or so. And that brings me back to my final point about using copy operations as backups. Restoration. As we've seen from our original examples, a reverse copy of the entire backup on F back to C would not restore your system. Certain critical files, such as the registry, would be missing. Your restored drive could not boot. You could recover data files from your backup and perhaps some other files, but that's about it. It wouldn't restore your entire system. So, if your intent is to back up everything so that in case of a failure you can simply and quickly replace a hard drive and restore everything, then a good backup program is really the only way to go. If, on the other hand, you already know what you are and are not backing up, a file copy can be a useful tool. In my opinion, though, it's only useful in addition to a proper full backup performed by a dedicated backup program. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3117. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.